Question for you. Do you still flag emails? If yes, then you must stop doing it. Now, what is wrong with flagging emails? Well, it's a pseudo task. We have Planner, which is the perfect place for creating a list of all your pending work. That's already there, so why create another list in inbox and confuse yourself? That's why flagging emails is bad. And tasks have so many different options. We have checklist, we have notes, we have attachments. All these fields are missing when mail is flagged as a task. That's why convert a mail to task. There are 8 ways of doing it. Whichever method you like, you choose. Let's start with the old version of Outlook. I know it is getting replaced with new version, but still there for at least a year. Drag the mail, drop it on task folder, just gets created. Problem with this approach is it makes a copy, and if there was an attachment, it doesn't come here. You want both? Then right drag drop means press the right mouse button while dragging and then drop. Gives you 3 options. You choose move instead of copy. The original mail with attachment becomes an attachment inside the task. So everything is good. Now we are going to have the new Outlook replacing the old one in future. So let's go to new Outlook. In fact, new Outlook is just a web version of Outlook. So whatever I'm showing now works with the new version of Outlook and browser version, or Outlook Web Access, as we used to call it. What do? You open the right side pane, which is called My Day. Now you drag and drop a mail, and then it'll ask you, do you want to convert it to a task or you want to convert it to a calendar entry? On the other hand, if you right click on a mail, all the way down Advanced Options, there is a Create a Task option. There is also something called Quick Steps. Apart from converting a mail to task, you want to do something else with it. For example, forward it to someone. Then you create a quick step. Add whatever you want. The first one is create a task. Second, in this case, as an example, is forward a mail. And I could have added any of the other actions as well. You create a set of actions and save it as a quick step. Select a mail and run the quick step. On the mobile, while you are reading the mail, you may think, oh, this is actually a task, so let's convert it. So top right, vertical 3 dots, which is ellipsis, more options, all the way down, create a task. And many people don't know this, while you're reading things in Teams, whether it is chat or channels, you can right click on any message and say create a task. The last one is Power Automate. At any step in Power Automate, if you want to create a task, add this action, configure it, and a task will get created. As you know, Power Automate works with 1,000 other apps, so this can be an important component of your automation workflow. So there you have it, 8 different methods. Choose the one you like and stop flagging mails. Share this with as many people as you can. Subscribe and click the bell icon and ask me questions. Suggest topics. I'll be happy to create more for you. And before you go, watch this video about how new Planner is revolutionizing the way you manage tasks. So that's it for now. See you next time. Thank you.